Here it is. It's the Gambit. Okay. It looks quite a beast. It looks quite different. It's a mortar hole this time. So I thought I'd do, without even looking at any targets, at least I'd talk through a little bit about the new mortar ship. Okay, and my thoughts. Clearly, it comes with obviously this new Rook mortar as well, and there's a new garrison battery to go with it. So let's have a little look and see what we think. Okay, then we can do with it. Right, here we are. We're in obviously ship a builder in the shipyard, and here it is. Here's the hull itself. Then, first and foremost, I think we noticed they've got 6 special slots and 6 armor slots, and then we have 8 weapon slots. The good thing about the weapon slots is that they are all suitable for countermeasures, so that could be worthy of note. It could be a countermeasure ship may help us, we'll see. Okay, but you do have the options then to fill this up with countermeasures, bearing in mind obviously Gale 4s, MDS 3s is the classic countermeasures for the garrison holes. Specials then, there aren't that many specials yet, so I won't say there's a spoiler alert, but just be precautious. They are going to release additional specials as this hull develops, including weapon systems. At the moment, the weapon that's out is not a limited weapon, and just like the previous garrison hull, they will be released later on, and probably the same with the armors at the moment. I think it's interesting to note already that this ship already has a massive amount in built-in explosion damage and a massive amount of built-in building damage as well. So, and it also has quite a lot of evade as well. Combat speed and turn speed is reasonable for a flat build. Okay. Forget about the sonar range. I like the build time. It's really, really good. I mean, obviously, I've got my buildings upgraded, but 21 hours and, well, 21 and a half hours is certainly pretty decent. I have got some ideas for builds at the moment, so we'll go through those. The other thing to note as well, I think, is this down the bottom of special abilities. A duplicate aura cap of 5, so that's 1 for each hull. Okay, then, which means this drone, okay, then, or this pawn that spawns basically when the ship is stationary. So it has to be stationary first, and you can select what it targets. Target selected enemy on spawn. So you select the enemy, and then you can pause, and then this thing will go towards that first target. Once it blows up then, okay, or if it does kill that target, it will then go to the next closest target. So just bear that in mind as well. It gives a 20% chance of, okay, of a 20% boost chance of a combat aura speed boost of 20%, as well as explosive damage 20% boost as well. I'm not 100% sure yet whether that's the drone gets that bonus or whether you get that bonus, but I have a funny feeling because it only lasts 10 seconds, and bearing in mind how it doesn't say how far this drone goes, it looks to me like it'll affect the drone. The only thing it doesn't tell you on here is how much damage the drone gives out. So that's something that we'll have to probably decide as we go through and see the actual targets after the raid, probably next week or week after. Anyway, it's interesting that the combat speed is 90 and the turn speed is 65. So these things are going to race forward, but they can't turn very fast. So that's going to be interesting. Now, like I said, maximum drone activity is active drones is 1. Obviously, is that 1 per ship? But I think it probably is because it says a duplicate or a cap of 5. If the aura is duplicated or a cap of 1, only 1 instance of that aura can be affected. Okay, so the duplicated aura is 5, so I assume you get 5 drones, 1 per ship. That's my thought about it anyway, but we'll see. What else is there about this hull to say is basically it seems to me that actually the weight limit, which is quite large, with the current weapon systems that we've got and the current specials, there's definitely more to come because we're very much underweight. So I will load a couple of ideas that I've got just to speed things up to make it quicker. Okay, so this is the first one. This is absolutely a vanilla build. Okay, there are many other things we can do, but this is then filling up 6 slots with the Rook mortar. Okay, and the armor slots were the best armor that we've got at the moment for the garrison, which is the 10.5. Okay, then obviously garrison scourge armor. 3M and 3X. I haven't seen the targets yet, so we'll just go with 3 of each just to give us a weight idea. And then specials. Well, on Hefe's show last week, we talked about specials quickly. The best thing we've got at the moment is the K2 bombardment system and obviously the brand new Garrison X battery, which comes in this event. Then we're going to go across then for an engine. So far, the best one is probably the Finray engine. I don't think there's anything else. I don't think there's a better engine than that one just as yet. Okay, and then the ascension mortar system as well, because that gives you a good bit of projectile speed, which also helps countermeasures as well, but also helps mortar reload. And then at the bottom here, this may not be the right assistance for your countermeasures. It depends on whether we've got missiles incoming and mortars incoming. Okay, but this one does help both those areas. Okay, so it does help quite considerably then on the countermeasures for anti-mortar and anti-missile. So at the moment, that's the one I'm going with. And because it's already got built-in evade as well, for my last special, I've gone at the moment for Guidance Scrambler 3, because that's the best one. Unless we need some stun effect, okay, and then I would anti-stun effect, sorry, and then I'd move that across to the limited option, which is over here. And he says, and it would be down here, which is Agility System 4. If we don't need too much evade, obviously, and we can speed these ships up, at the moment, turn is 100, and we can use, obviously, the good old Hyper 30, and that then should bring us then with a combat and turn speed of 100 flat across both, which is quite nice. Well, I haven't seen the targets, like I said, so I have no idea how fast this thing needs to be or how much evade is going to help us. But at the moment, that's 59.5. And then go back to the Guidance Scrambler, which is obviously going to be higher, but it's going to be slower. Okay, and that gives us 70.8. Bear in mind, I do have all my buildings upgraded as well, so just bear that in mind. So that's about it. So that's a vanilla build in generic terms, okay? Other things that we could do. And here we go. Here's a full power hull, basically. If you were thinking of saying, well, actually, I only want one or two countermeasure ships or a single countermeasure ship and the rest of them are full power, of the specials available at the moment, I believe this is probably the better one to go for. If you want to have that sort of like a slower combat speed one, 88 and 100, that's because I'm using Guidance Scrambler 3 as opposed to, obviously, going back again. And we could have used, where it is, yeah, the Hyper 30 as well. So there we go, back to the 100-100. So those are the two options, I think, for speed. The good thing about this one here, it's extremely heavy, this reloader, but it does give you explosive damage of plus 30%. With all these things in place, okay, look at the crazy amount of damage you are doing, okay, which means that obviously they're trying to wipe out all previous versions of this garrison hull or previous garrison hulls, okay, and because at the moment, with already what was built into the hull, this one, look, is 2,000 or over 2,000 on the building damage, and on the explosive damage, we're at nearly 900% bonus as well. So that's a crazy amount of bonus damage already built in. So that's it. Total build look, including the flat hull, if you weren't building it already, 8 days, 17 hours each. So it's very much like the previous Garrison fleet. It's going to be quite quick to build these, I think. Which will be quite reasonable. Bear in mind that if you build the hull first and then put all the specials afterwards, if your buildings are upgraded, it'll be considerably less than this time overall. Crews, I suppose. Molotov Maidens is going to be a good one with obviously the extra splash bonus that you get. And obviously the building damage crew as well is another one you could look at. If it's evade, obviously it'll be Sea Serpents. There are a few others that you could use. You can get some critical hit ones as well, but I think those are the basic ones to start with. Anyway, that's it. That's as far as I've gone so far. It's just a first look. It's just to give you some sort of idea. Most of these things, you know, this one, or probably not that one, but definitely this, I'd say this, and maybe the K2, because it's only a tier 9, that will probably change in the future. The armor is bound to change, and so are the weapon systems once we get to the limited ones. So this is just provisional for the first couple of months. Don't panic if you're not going to get into these straight away. Okay, the other targets in the FM will still be there for a little while, so you can still use your current garrison fleet. That's it. I hope it helped. Anyway, TSM out.